starts when I was 10 year old boy. When I was 10 year old boy, as a family, we went to a Swami called Annamalai Swami. He's an enlightened master, great enlightened master of Arunachala, disciple of Raman Maharishi, Bhagavan Sri Raman Maharishi. Just, he was a personal assistant of Bhagavan. He was the only one who used to bathe him, who used to touch his body and bathe him. Such an intimate disciple. Of course, 10-year-old boy, what he will think to go when he goes to see a master? Will he give a sugar candy or will he give a banana? That is the only expectation I can have from him. And that is the only expectation I had from him. When I went there, he was talking to a group of devotees that we are not body. We are beyond pain and sufferings. No pain affects us. I was just surprised. How can this be? He says, no pain affects us. But when my mom beats, I am feeling the pain. In India, kids will be beaten if they do something wrong. When my mom beats, I feel pain. But he says there is no pain. Anyhow, I went back to the house. I was thinking continuously. Some of the words were ringing in my ears. I was not able to forget the words. Finally, I decided to check. I took a knife and cut my thigh to see whether there is pain or not. Still now the mark is there, a big mark. A nice deep cut. Still now the mark is there in the thigh. And of course, I had a pain and mom gave again few blows and took me to the hospital. What fool, what have you done? They took me to the hospital, did first aid and put all the stitchings. And after a few days, I went back to that Swami again. And I told him, you see, what have you taught me? You told me don't have pain, suffering. I went and cut myself. And I'm having pain, not only that, my mom is beating me. Then he said, he was so compassionate. And he just patted me and told me, oh my son, don't worry. You just do this small meditation. You will understand what I said. You might have had pain now. You might have cut your thighs now. You are so feeling, so much of love and feeling. He said, it's almost his blessing that I will realize that meditation technique. He said that you will experience there is no pain and suffering. You are beyond pain and suffering. He just like that he blessed. And he said, the attitude, the testing on yourself is the greatest attitude. Don't worry about that. Now you might have had pain. You might have felt that you have done a mistake. But don't worry, that attitude itself will lead you. That checking attitude, that ready to risk, that attitude itself will lead you beyond the pain and suffering. He gave me a small meditation technique. I did not even know it's a meditation technique. What 10-year-old boy can understand? He told me, just start searching from where thoughts are coming. And he told me, are you there? I said, yes, I am there. I am feeling myself. Start searching from where the thoughts are coming. A very simple thing. Of course, I was not habituated to meditate, or I was not a small boy, what do you know about meditation? But I used to just sit and watch very playfully, relaxed way, from where my thoughts are coming. I'll close my eyes and see from where my thoughts are coming. So when I was 12, 2 years I used to, whenever I find time, not regular meditation or tapas like this, no. Whenever I find time, I used to casually sit and do. When I was 12, I was sitting under the Arunachala hillock, evening. Later on I discovered that day was Buddha Purnima. Of course, that time I do not know it was Buddha Purnima. I was sitting on a rock, evening, trying to play with that meditation. That's what I can say. 4:30 to 6. In India, Sandhya means 4:30 to 6, that is the time sun sets. Sandhya. I was seeing from where the thoughts are coming. I was just searching the source of the thoughts. Suddenly something broke. I felt clearly something is broken and something is opened. I don't know how you will understand. Simply I started seeing complete 360 degree. You all know 120 degree vision. 120 degree vision you know. If you turn your eyes, you can see. If you turn your whole head, you can see the 360. But my eyes closed, no head movement, no body movement. Simply I started seeing complete 360 degree. This side 360 degree and this side 360 degree. Difficult to comprehend. Try to understand. I was able to see the hillock which was in front of me, and the temple which was this side, city which was this side, and the temple which was back side, and the whole thing in one single second. Not only this is 360 degree, and this 360 degree also. The sky and the hillock and the rock on which I am sitting, the back side, the whole thing. This side 360 and this side 360. If you understand the roof and the cutout and the chair back side and this side, this portion of the chair, bottom of the chair and the video camera. And this side, this podium and the plant and the cutout and speaker and the video camera. Again, the whole, this side 360 degree and this side 360 degree. I started seeing. And not only I started seeing, next moment I just felt the whole thing is me. The idea of me is lost. Before that, I was having the idea only, this is me. And the moment I started feeling, the whole thing is me. The stone is me. The tree is me. The hillock is me. The temple is me. The sky is me. Everything has started vibrating with the feeling, I am that. There is no difference consciously. How much you feel your body with the same sensitivity, I felt the whole existence. Maybe 3 days that state continued. I came out of the, my body started moving. I started walking after 3-4 hours. Maybe in 3-4 hours, I became normal physically. But mentally, that fever, like a fever kind of mood, it was a joyful fever that stayed for 3 days continuously. And the moment I became alright, the first thought was the fear. I thought some ghost has caught me. I do not know it's a spiritual experience. Some ghost has possessed me. And I ran to that. One Mataji was there. I ran to her. I asked her what happened to me. She held my hand and told, no, no, you are not possessed by ghost, you are possessed by God. So she consoled me and she gave me food for 3-4 days to take care of my body and all those things. And but never, next 3 months I went near that rock. I used to have a terrible fear that there is a ghost sitting. If I go, it may catch me again. I never went near that rock. But I always had a deep feeling to have that experience again. One side, it's just such a juicy feeling. It's like you have fallen in love with somebody and you want to see that person, but the society is not accepting it. Just the same kind of feeling. One side fear that again it may catch me and I do not know what is happening to me. It's beyond my control. The other side, such a deep joy and ecstasy. So it took little time. Then slowly I gathered courage and started working towards that experience again and again, to have that same experience. Of course, the search started. I started trying different meditation techniques. The more I try, more more it escaped from me. The more I drive, more I was meant to chase. Continued when I was 13 and a half. I ran away once to north, leaving the house. But I came back again because I was not able to survive and get my food. Of course, later on, second time, third time when I went away to north. I was there in the north. Gujarat is the best place. Not that there are so many Gujaratis, because of that I am telling. Really, according to my experience, Gujarat and Karnataka, these two are the states to be blessed. I always give my heartfelt blessings to these two states. So much taking care of the sadhus and mahatmas, and so much of such a good religious feelings, and so much of the tapas and sadhana is respected. That is why Lakshmi showers on Gujarat. I always tell them, they are worthy of having Lakshmi. See the Gujarat and Karnataka, these two states, Lakshmi showers on them. She is showering on them. They have everything. Only these two states, people are very, very comfortable. If you see in the survey way, they don't work much, but they are showered. The physical work is not much, because there is no need. They are showered. They are worthy of having Lakshmi because their attitude, their lifestyle. You will never suffer for food in the Gujarat and Karnataka, because the Lakshmi and Annamurti, they shower on Gujarat and Karnataka. Anyhow, next time, maybe it was 15 and a half, second time I ran away again. And then after that, again I came back. Third time, it was 70. That time, that was the last I escaped. Literally escaped, because they were trying to catch me and forcibly put me in marriage. I was a 17-year-old boy. They were afraid that I'll escape. At least they can do something. In that way, they can keep in the house. Was not somehow possible. I had an elder brother, so unless that guy gets married, I can't, they can't put me in the marriage. In the India, the tradition is there. Only the elders has to be first get married, only then next guy. They are not able to get any girl for him. So I thought God saved me. And next time I ran away. Of course, length and breadth of India, I wanted. Under length and breadth of India, doing different kinds of meditation techniques, tapas, staying under the trees, at the Himalayas, Gaurikund, I had the Mahavadharmavaji darshan. That was one of the turning point which gave me the tremendous inspiration, because that was the time I was tired. I felt that enough. That was the time I was feeling tired, but he gave me the big courage and the energy in Gaurikund. Then I came down to Kashi. Kashi, I had a wonderful experience, death experience. I'm speaking about that in the pictorial biography. You can see the photograph where I had the death experience, Manikarnika. Manikarnika, I had a death experience. Then I broke my backbone. I was traveling in military truck. In India, military truck will not have a seat. They will have only wooden plank. Any of you have seen military truck? Military jeep. In that, they will put only the wooden plank and bolt nut. I was traveling with them in the jeep. All people give so much of respect for sadhus, you do not know. The pothole, they, with such a speed, they put me in the, they put the vehicle in the pothole, the whole vehicle was shaken. Then I had a fracture in the backbone. They wanted to treat and do the bandage. I never accepted. I'm just by hand. That is the first time I felt. I saw how healing happens. I put my hand and saw the energy is being flooded and got healed. Simply it got healed. So that was the first healing. Narmada, Madhya Pradesh. That is a place. I had the last ultimate experience. It was the January 1st, 2000. Later on, I found the date because that time I do not know calendar, all those things. Later on, I scanned and picked up the date. The same, my birth date. Like a drama. I don't know how both fell in the same day and the same time. It was night. I was just sitting. That was the time I had the second big depression and threw away all the sadhanas. No sadhana, no japa, nothing. I was just relaxing on the bank of Narmada, moon, beautiful moon. I was stretching my legs and almost lying on a rock and enjoying the whole beauty. Maybe 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, midnight. Maybe 11, because the moon was there, so midnight. Suddenly, I saw the relaxation was becoming more and more and more deeper, deeper and deeper. And simply the verbalization started disappearing. It's like you pour a tumbler of water that goes and disappears into the river. Slowly, 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 the dewdrop has just become with emotion. Never came back.
What was that experience like when that happened?
What was... I can describe few words. Fully it is not possible to describe, but few words. That's what yesterday I was describing. The inner chattering totally disappeared. Now also, when I'm speaking to you, I'm speaking. When I stop, this gap, there is no words. Like a tape recorder. I can talk, when I stop. Over. That is what they are surprised by that research. They say that such a deep silence can never happen. And just by a pill, and they put me in that QEEG, all those electrodes they inserted. They said, Swamiji, you can meditate. They thought it will take some 10 minutes or half an hour. I said nothing. Closed the eyes and simply the gram dropped. Closed the eyes and tack, gram dropped. Person who is doing research, he got frightened. Are you get up. It started showing. Straight line. Okay. There is no inner chatter. The inner chatter is totally not there. It disappeared. Next thing, the idea of basic sex disappeared. The male and female concept disappeared. Just as I'm holding this kerchief in my hand, I'm holding this body. Of course, body is male body, physically male body, that is different. But the idea, the being, never gets identified with the idea that I'm a male or I'm a female. That idea of male or female is not there. With a lot of difficulty, I have to remind myself, male or female, the idea is not there. The third, tremendous ecstasy, even the ecstasy word is not enough. And that also, they are saying that their research, there is a thing called D-spot. Doctors must be knowing. Dopamine. Dopamine chemical is released when you get into some pleasure. They say that where from the dopamine is released, that point is just stimulated. Like a flood, they say that dopamine is getting released into the system. When I just close the eyes and enter into that ecstasy, they say that like a flood, the dopamine is getting released. And the next thing, that is the important thing, the idea of boundary is lost. The very idea of boundary, I belong to this body or this body belongs to me, is lost. This, how much I feel one with this body, sensitive with this body, same amount of sensitivity I could feel with the whole cosmos, the existence, universe. If I starts the world is lost.